The story begins when your reason becomes truly self-aware and begins to think for himself and of himself, an independence which entails isolation from the divine family. It is, in fact, adolescence, when a child becomes something of a law unto himself. The loss of unquestioning intimacy with one's parents is a very real one. The first phase of your reason's self-creation was his adolescent withdrawal into isolation, where he attempted to bring his changing existence under control by making rational laws. Your reason promulgates his laws, which he explicitly describes as the result of his struggles with the unconscious sexual and violent impulses of the id. In Freudian terms, he proclaims himself the superego. He is himself supreme God, whose rule he announces, here alone, I in books formed of metals have written the secrets of wisdom, the secrets of dark contemplation. My fightings and conflicts die out with terrible we'll be right back. created with hands up in horror. He is turned away from the viewer because his dismay at his creation is something he keeps secret. Dark, revolving, and silent activity, unseen and tormenting passion, an activity unknown and horrid, a self-contemplating shadow. First I fought with the fire.